Vsauce, Kevin here. In my video about how hot your internal organs are, I wondered if you could cook something inside your body. Well, it turns out there are a couple of cooking techniques you can actually do with your body oven. First of all, your body is 37 degrees Celsius. If it's that hot outside, you could fry an egg on the roof of your car. The surface hits 65 degrees and higher, so why can't you at least, like, soft boil an egg in your mouth? Or in not your mouth? Maybe you can. Let's get the obvious stuff out of the way first. Even with a fever, your body tops out at about 42 degrees Celsius before brain damage starts to happen. It's no use cooking food for a brain-dead body. Even if you did go higher, so like your friend Harold could eat your body food, you'd probably die long before the chicken parmesan inside you cooked. Heat stroke is happening around 40.5 degrees, which can cause seizures and multi-organ disruptions, but you can survive that. You just cannot sustain temperatures higher than that, so we're looking at 42 degrees Celsius as an absolute maximum. And look, pregnant moms don't cook their babies. Fetuses are about half a degree Celsius warmer than the mothers they're growing in, but that's fine for their thermoregulation. Unborn babies have their own system, so buns in the oven, of course, aren't actually baking. So, if you can't get your body super hot, what options do you have for cooking food inside your meat puppet? Before anyone out there tries to soft boil an egg in themselves, we need to talk about what cooking even is. It's actually important to answering this question. We all know not to eat raw meat unless it's carefully selected and prepared, like sushi or steak tartare. And most people have a sort of revulsion to even the thought of eating raw meat. It's slimy, chewy, and weird. You're programmed not to like it for your own safety, because our ancestors have been cooking food for 2,000 years. 20,000 years. 2 million years for 2 million years. Here's why. Cooking makes food easier to chew. It usually improves the flavor, like the caramelized brown char on meat from the Maillard process, and it makes the food last longer. It's also safer because it kills harmful bacteria and parasites. No one wants worms inside them. I mean, I'm sure somebody wants worms inside them. There's always an outlier. You know who you are. The 1991 discovery of the 5,000-year-old frozen man Otzi in Italy revealed he was carrying a wooden box to transport hot embers wrapped in maple leaves and a complex kit for starting new fires. Imagine instead of carrying around your phone, you carried around a hot George Foreman grill. The food safety aspect of killing bacteria mattered to Otzi, and it matters to us. According to the USDA, most meat needs to be cooked to 63 degrees Celsius and poultry to 74 degrees Celsius to be guaranteed safe. But that's not really necessary. It is for restaurants, because at those temperatures, you can be 100% sure that no bacteria survive. They want to achieve instant pasteurization so they don't poison dozens of people at a time. The USDA made these rules to be clear and foolproof. Instant pasteurization happens for chicken at 74 degrees Celsius, so that's the rule. But if you don't need it instantly, you can cook it much lower, like 60 degrees Celsius, to keep the meat soft and juicy. It'll just take half an hour at that temperature to ensure all the bacteria is gone. Lower temperature, longer time. And from Fiji to Samoa to Morocco to the Americas, everyone's always had a sense of this. Slow cooking fire pits were a staple in most indigenous cultures because they were simple to build, easy to use, and they worked. The better our cooking technology got, the more we seem to forget we don't necessarily need to blast food with heat. The British physicist Benjamin Thompson helped drive the understanding of thermodynamics in the 1800s, but he was stunned that he left a joint of meat in a drying oven overnight and was amazed when the next morning he found that the meat was tender and fully cooked. Welcome to the concept of the slow cooker, Benjamin. That guy would have been blown away by dump dinners. But it's easy to cook something with a fire or a crock pot. But for this brain-wrinkling exercise, we want to cook with our bag of bones. Imagine, if you will, that you're in the Australian outback. It's 50 degrees Celsius. You strip down to your Spider-Man undies, apply the highest possible SPF sunscreen all over your body to mitigate sunburn, and you lay a raw steak on your stomach. If you had a constant system of covering your torso and legs with cold, wet towels to combat the creep of heat stroke, you could slow cook and flip at intervals to probably get your stomach steak to rare or medium rare without dying. The human body isn't a great oven, but it could be a pan. But I mean, that's really dangerous and ridiculous. You could just cook the steak on a rock and hang out in the shade and box a kangaroo or whatever. I don't know what you want to do. If you boosted your body temperature and stuffed raw fish in your mouth, you could come very close to cooking it after about an hour. At 40 degrees Celsius, a fish fillet about 15 millimeters thick, or the width of your fingernail, cooks in under 20 minutes. That's not a bad solution for the body cooking question. We are making progress. What about eggs? No. No, it doesn't matter where you put them inside you. For eggs, you're going to need more heat because you're going to be about 50 degrees Celsius short. What can you do? Well, fermentation happens inside your body as useful bacteria extract energy from carbohydrates and make lactic acid and intestinal gas. It's mostly done in the large intestine, and it can actually produce enough ethanol to impair you like drunkenness. Auto-brewery syndrome is real and can even happen inside the bladder. It's a really rare condition where your body makes you drunk from the inside out. Cruciferous vegetables like broccoli, cauliflower, and Brussels sprouts are famous for fermenting during digestion and blowing up your stomach like a hot air balloon, and then you gotta let the air out of the balloon. I'm talking about farting. That's what farting is. So you could ferment sauerkraut, kimchi, kombucha, or yogurt inside your body. It's just hard to get it out intact. But is fermentation cooking? If you consider fermentation under the umbrella of cooking, then so is dehydrating. And you could vacuum seal fresh herbs with a moisture-absorbing desiccant, like you know those little silica gel packets that come in everything and you're not supposed to eat them, so don't? Well, if you hypothetically vacuum sealed one of those with some fresh herbs and then swallowed it, that plastic pouch is safe even in boiling water, so your body won't break it down and it'll just pass through you intact. By the time it comes out, you've subjected those herbs to probably 24 hours of body temperature warmth and absorbed most, if not all, of the water. Your body would have cooked perfectly dehydrated oregano for your spicy chicken and lime taquitos. I'm going to call this new technique pass-through cooking. It's a real thing now. Pass-through cooking. I invented it. Don't do it. Don't blame me if something bad happens because you swallowed. Don't do that. You could actually do the same exact thing with meat to make beef jerky or ostrich biltong. That's cured and dried anywhere from about 16 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees. You might need 2 or even 3 rounds of pass-through, if you know what I mean. So you'd have to wash and disinfect the vacuum-sealed pouch each time, of course. But if you didn't use a protective pouch, not only would it never dry out, but you'd just digest it as usual, with stomach acids breaking it down and your digestive system processing it. That's called eating, not cooking. And you're probably familiar with eating. All right, so where do we land on cooking stuff inside yourself? Well, you can't make eggs Benedict in your mouth, stomach, or elsewhere, but you can dry the parsley to garnish it, and if you don't mind passing through sealed strips of pork belly about 20 times in 2 weeks, you could even wet cure the bacon to go along with it, and maybe have some body kombucha to wash it all down, if you could get it out safely. All right, if you want me to answer any of your weird questions in a future video, pop over to the brand new Vsauce 2 subreddit and ask away. If you want to put wrinkles on your brain all year round, get the new Curiosity Box Platinum plan. It'll save you money, get you faster shipping, and you're guaranteed a full year of Vsauce at your doorstep. So, do that. And as always, thanks for watching.